Hey guys, this is how I turned my boring gray wall into a floral wall inspired by Pinterest. I bought a bunch of fake flower bouquets from Walmart. They were only about $1.50 each, and then I cut them separately with wire cutters. Then I went to Goodwill and found this mirror for only $1.99. And then I decided to spray paint it white just so it could look better with the gray wall. Once it dried, I hung it up and started to lay the flowers around it. I used clear tacks to pin the flowers to the wall just because tape really wasn't working out. But this is how it ended up turning out, and I'm honestly pretty happy with it.
Okay, I'm bored in a house and I'm in a house bored. Bored in a house and I'm in a house bored. Bored in a motherfucker in a house bored, and I'm bored in a motherfucker in a house bored. Bored in a house, bored in a house bored. Bored in a house, bored in a house bored.
Common design mistakes that you might be making. Carpet size. So often I see people select a carpet that is just too small. Especially in a living room, carpets are meant to section off the room and should fit all the furniture. Curtain height. Curtains are not meant to be hung directly over the window. Instead, they should be hung almost to the ceiling and should be long enough to touch the floor. Scale and plan. It's so important to measure your space and check to make sure that the dimensions of your furniture are the right scale for the room and in relationship to each other. The last thing you want is furniture that doesn't fit into the space or is too small.
Can I get a kiss? And can you make it last forever? I said I'm about to go to war. I'm not know if I'm gonna see you again.
I said, okay, dokey.
I can give you model with these double A cups.
One morning, I woke up with the idea to make something cute for my dorm room, so I decided to try something I found on Pinterest. The directions were pretty straightforward, so I was like, what could go wrong? The pink flowers I had were too bright, so I thought that I could paint them purple. Big mistake. Not only did they look ugly, but they were crusty too. Then I was like, bro, maybe I can dye these. I let the flowers soak in the dye for a couple days, and it barely made a difference, so I said screw it and just used the white and purple flowers. I lined them up and started tying them together with some embroidery thread that I found in the garage, and then painted the dowel white with my main man, Breve. Breve got bored real fast, so I read him a book and he seemed to enjoy it. Brownie points if you can tell me what book that is. Then I assembled whatever the heck that is, and it looked like trash. Thanks, Pinterest. So I hot glued some telephone wire to stiffen it, and then started randomly adding other crap to hide the wire. Now it looks freaking dope, but I have no idea how I'm gonna safely transport it from Washington to Iowa.
And I'll be singing la 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 la. You're breaking me la 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 la. You're breaking me la 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 la. You're breaking me la 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 la. I'm just right here dancing around to the rhythm that you play when you're breaking my heart.